everybody. So I know I haven't been making videos at all since my dance studio opened, so now I'm back because I managed to find a break and have some me time and do a nice video. So today I'm going to share with you my super long overdue Korean makeup and beauty haul. And I've been loving all these products. I've been using them over the past like 6 months that I haven't been doing videos, so I thought I would just share this with you. So first up, I got a lot of lip products, and these are the Dear My Blooming Lips Top Lipsticks, and this is the shade Orange 204 and PK005. So I'm just going to slowly swatch these for you. I really love their packaging, it's just so cute. So this is the orange one. You can see that it's just really gorgeous coral shade, and I love how it's really buildable. So this is how it looks like. And I also got the pink shade one, which is the one I am currently wearing on my lips right now. And this is how it looks like. I'm just going to swatch this next to you, so you can see that it's really bright, sweet pink, and I absolutely love these two shades. And I like the fact that they do have that little bit of watery sheen to it after you apply it on your lips, and it doesn't last the whole day. You do have to keep reapplying it, especially after eating. So yep, these are just really nice, simple go-to lipsticks that I go to almost every day. And yep, I'm gonna move on to the next few. They're from Etude House, and these are the Vivid Pop Sticks that I got. And my friends actually got these for me when they went to Korea, so it's really a lot cheaper over there. This is, I don't know what the shade is. Doesn't say here. But anyway, this is a really nice coral pink color, and I'm just gonna swatch it here for you. And you can see that it's a lot more pigmented than the Blooming Lip Top Lipsticks. And this is an orange color, just like that. It's just really pretty and very wearable, especially because orange was the summer color in Korea. And then this is the bright coral color. You can see here. It's kind of similar to this one, but it's a little bit more bright and pink. And finally, this darker red color as well in the Vivid Pop Stick. And my hand is gonna run out of space for swatching. I like how this red doesn't turn out very red, but more watermelon cherry red. And I absolutely love that about it here. Those were the lip products that I got my friend Isabel to help me get from Korea. Thank you so much, Isabel, for getting those products for me. Other lip products that I got my friend Noelle to get for me from Korea were the famous 3 Concept Eyes Lip Laquers. These 3CE lip laquers are absolutely gorgeous. I don't think I can say the same for any other lipstick or lip laquers that I've tried. I've tried Makeup Forever ones, and those really stay, but they feel really sticky, whereas these don't. These really leave a very nice powdery finish. It's like as if you didn't put anything on your lips at all, and it just feels really smooth. It applies really pigmented. I'm just gonna swatch these for you real quick on my hand to show you the colors that I got, but I really love all of them, and I think that they are just amazing. So first up, I'm going to swatch this color in Showtime. Here. You can see just one application is so pigmented already. And it's just really easy to apply. And then this bright fuchsia pink color. This is the color in Pink Boom, and I've used this a couple of times already. You can see how glossy the finish is. But it does dry a little bit more matte. It does dry matte and powdery after this, I can show you. And then this slightly more purplish, light pink color here, and this is the shade in Disco. I love how the applicator feels as well. It makes it really easy to apply. It's a really gorgeous pink. And the last two colors, this is a little bit more neutral. This is Super Coral, and I use this more for an everyday look. It's gorgeous. I think this is one of their most popular shades. And finally, the more nude, neutral shade here that I have is Bon Bon, and I think their names are just so cute. So Bon Bon is great for a nude lip look. And I like that it's a little bit more on the warm side. So these are the shades that I got for the 3CE Lip Laquers. Thank you, Noelle, for helping me bring these back. And they're so, so good. I absolutely love them. A little goes a long way. Sometimes if I don't want it to be so pigmented on my lips, I just take a little bit, put them in the middle, and I dab it with my finger to apply it. And it just really lasts the whole day. It just does not rub off. It's not, you don't, when you drink water, it doesn't come off. When you kiss, it doesn't come off. So it's really, really good, really wearable, really long lasting. If it's a little bit on the pricey side, if you do want to get a good high-end lip product, then I would suggest that you get these 3CE lip lacquers. Yep, finally, the last thing that I got my friends to get for me from Korea was the Etude House Face Designing Brightener. And I've been seeing so many YouTube people use this, and I've been really wanting to get my hands on it. So I got this one, and this is the Wannabe Face Shade. And I think they have a new one, which is the white one. Okay, it's not really new, it was new 6 months ago. I actually wanted my friend to get that one for me, but when she went to Korea, it was completely sold out. So that's quite sad. But I got this one, this is the famous one. And yep, I'm using it on my face right now to highlight my nose, under my eyes, my forehead, and my cupid's bow, highlights on my cheeks. It's a really great highlighter, I highly recommend it, and it's really affordable as well. Okay, so that's the end of the Korean beauty products that I got my friends to help me get from Korea. But when I was here, I couldn't wait for the Laniege BB cream. So Deo actually knew that I really wanted it, and he got it for me. And I'm really happy because I've been using this every day ever since I got my NARS foundation in my last video. I got this after that, and this has been my go-to foundation every day, and it's just really amazing. I have it on my face right now. It's really great on the go. I've brought this on me for trips, for performances, and it's just so easy to touch up as well. I love the packaging. It is kind of bulky, but it does feel very light. It's not one of those heavy ones. And I've used it quite a lot. You can see it's quite dirty. I really love the sponge that it comes with. I don't use any other way to apply this. I think this just works perfectly with the formula of the BB cushion. And it just looks like that. It's easy, you just press. And you can see the product, and then you just dab it. All right. So nothing much here. I think a lot of YouTubers have already like gone through this. I can just swatch a little bit for you. Here. Not sure if it's showing up on camera, but you can see that it's just it gives a really flawless finish. It applies really easy, it's blendable, it's buildable, and it has light to medium coverage, and it has SPF in it. So it's SPF 50 plus, lasts really longer, a lot longer than a lot of the other BB creams and foundations that I have that only SPF 25 plus plus plus. Surprisingly, even with the SPF, I'm sorry I didn't do a thorough review because I haven't had time, but mark my words when I say that when I did flash photography, it did not leave a white cast on my face, because I went out wearing this at night with my friends, and it did not leave a white cast when I took photos under lighting with my friends. So I highly recommend you guys try this out. It's pretty expensive, but I think it's really worth it, and they do give an extra packaging of the refill for the BB cushion sponge, so that lasts like up to 2 years if you don't open it from the packaging. And this has been lasting me the past 6 months, and it's still going strong. and I think I can use it for a really long time. And like I said, a little goes a long way. It's really blendable and really buildable. So yeah, I really, really enjoy using this, and I think Laniege has done a really good job with this BB cushion. Okay, and finally, lastly, just to show you what else I got when they managed to get the Laniege BB cream, I actually also got the Laniege pack set. It's the Essential Care Trial Set in Light, and it's just really great because this was really cheap. Like, I bought this, and then I could get this for like an extra $39. So I'm not sure if they still have that promotion, because this was like half a year ago. I'm so sorry, I'm so late. But just want to let you know that Laniege always has really great promotions in stores, and you can ask them like, oh, if I get this, what else can I get? The store people are really nice. There was this lady that was helping me throughout this whole thing. She even helped me label like which one am I supposed to use first. So this Essential Care Trial Set is really great. It gives me a lot of stuff. It has like the multi cleanser, the skin refiner, toner, the balancing emulsion light control moisturizer, a serum, a water sleeping pack, and a water sleeping, and a gel cream. Yeah, a water sleeping pack and a gel cream. So it really comes with a lot of stuff for like $39, less than $50. I think this is just amazing. Yeah, and it's really great for travel as well. So yeah, that brings me to the end of my Korean beauty makeup haul, and I'm just really sorry that I haven't had time to do match videos or any videos at all. I really feel bad to all my subscribers, especially when I think like 6 months ago, before I opened my studio, I did do a few videos and I said I was gonna do more, and then I didn't expect it to get this busy. I haven't had sleep for like months. I haven't been sleeping, I haven't been resting well, I have been falling sick, and I've been just working 24/7 because being a studio owner is just not easy. So bear with me. Thank you so much for staying on and supporting me and still subscribing. I will try my best to come up with like at least one video every month, or one in 2 months. Do let me know down in the description box below like what else you would like me to see, so that maybe I could focus on those when I'm doing my videos. So yeah, I'm going to stop rambling around, and I'll see you guys again soon in my next video. Bye!